Hello student, we are studying our course that is renewable energy sources, and in that we have studied the second chapter, that is photothermal applications. Now in that we have seen in our previous videos, that is the different types of collectors, that is the two types of the collector, that is a flat plate collector and the concentrating collector. And in our previous video, we have seen the different type of the concentrator or concentrating collectors, such as flat absorber with a flat reflector concentrator. Second is the cylindrical parabolic concentrator. Next one is the Fresnel lens concentrator. Next one is the compound parabolic concentrator. And another one is the collector with the fixed circular concentrator and moving absorber. And the last one is the paraboloid dish concentrating collector. These all are the different types of the concentrating collectors which we have been seen or which have been covered in our previous videos. Now also we have covered the brief discussion about that particular type of the concentrating collectors. And in this video we have to see the advantages and the disadvantages of the concentrating collector. So let's start with that. First is the advantages of the solar concentrating collectors. The first advantage is the reflecting surfaces requires less material and are structurally simpler than the flat plate collector. We seen about the flat plate collector. In a flat plate collector, the reflecting surface is very large, but as compared to flat plate collector, in a concentrating collectors, the reflecting surface requires less material and are structurally simpler than the flat plate collector. That means the structure of the concentrating collector is a simple as compared to flat plate collector. Second advantage is the absorber area of a concentrated system is smaller than that of a flat plate collector. That means the absorber area, that means the area on which radiations are incident and they get absorbed by that area. So this absorber area is a smaller in a flat plate collector. In a concentrating collector as compared to flat plate collector. That means the absorber area is small. So we are able to obtain the maximum intensity in that particular absorber area because it is small. Therefore, the solar intensity is greater for solar concentration. That means the area is exposed for the absorption is small. So that in that particular area, we will get the maximum intensity of the solar radiation. Third advantage is due to smaller absorber area, the heat lost per unit area is smaller in a solar concentrated, and hence the working fluid can attain higher temperature. All these advantages are depend on each other. That means if the absorber area is small, therefore the heat loss per unit area is also small. That means if area is exposed to the solar radiation for the absorption is small, therefore the heat loss only in that particular area. So heat loss per unit is also less, and so that the solar concentrated attains the maximum temperature. That means the working fluid can attain the higher temperature. The working fluid which is in the solar concentrated, which is used for heating purpose or in order to get the heat, so it attain the higher temperature or maximum temperature. And this is the advantage of the solar concentrating collector. Now the next advantage is due to high temperature attained by concentrators, the heat energy stored per unit volume is larger than the flat plate collector. As we seen all above the advantages, due to all these advantages, the heat attained or energy stored per unit volume in the concentrator is large as compared to flat plate collector. Suppose as we consider above, there is no heat loss. That means very less heat loss because there is a less absorption area. So the heat energy lost और the convection and conduction processes are less due to less absorption area. So heat energy stored per unit volume is larger because there is a maximum temperature. We are able to attain the maximum temperature in a smaller absorber area, so that we will get the maximum intensity and the temperature of the working fluid is also maximum. So the heat energy stored per unit volume is also larger than the flat plate collector. And this is the advantage, main advantage of the concentrating collector over a flat plate collector. Next advantage is the concentrating system can be used for electric power generation but not used for the heating or cooling. If we are not using the concentrating system or concentrating collector for the heating or cooling purposes, then we can be used for electric power generation. That means there is a both use, that is the generation, it is used for the generation of the electric power and as well as for heating and cooling purposes. So this is the advantage of the concentrating systems. Next advantage is the total useful time in a year is larger for solar concentrated than the flat plate collector. That means the total useful time in a year is larger as compared to flat plate collector, because if we have the less intensity of the solar radiation, then even if we have the less intensity of the solar radiation, we are able to collect small amount of heat, or we are able to heat the working fluid which is present in the solar concentrated. So the total useful time in a year is larger as compared to flat plate collector within a solar concentrated. These all are the advantages of the concentrating collector over a flat plate collector. So the concentrating collector, which are useful more than that of the flat plate collectors. So these all are the disadvantages. Now the next is the disadvantages of the solar concentrating collectors. It has some disadvantages also. So the first disadvantage is the only beam radiation can be collected and the diffuse radiation cannot be collected. As we seen, there are two types of the radiation, that is the beam radiation and the diffuse radiation. In a solar concentrating collectors, only beam radiation can be collected, but diffuse radiation cannot be collected but in very small quantity. So this is the disadvantage of the solar concentrating collectors. The next disadvantage is the due to reflecting system, tracking is required and it introduces a certain amount of complexity in the design. That means there is a reflecting system in a concentrating collectors to follow the sun path. So the tracking is required to follow the sun path, and due to this tracking there is a complexity in the design. That means there is a complex, this is the complex in the design. So this is the disadvantage of the solar concentrating collectors. And due to the tracking system, also cost is high. Therefore the cost of the concentrating collectors is high as compared to flat plate collector, because in flat plate collector there is no tracking system, or tracking system is not required for the reflecting system. So this is the disadvantage of the concentrating collector. Next disadvantage is the additional requirement is required to retain the quality of a reflecting surface against dust, weather, oxidation. That means in the concentrating collector, reflecting system require extra maintenance. That is to retain the quality of reflecting surface against dust. That means there is a deposition of dust on the reflecting surface, then we are not able to collect the maximum solar radiation, or this surface is not able to reflect all the solar radiation. So this is the reflection is poor due to dust. So the cleaning is required. That means the additional requirement for the concentrating collector. Also due to weather and oxidation. Suppose the material get oxidized due to surrounding. So this precaution is also taken into account. So this is the disadvantage. Next disadvantage is the concentrating collector. In a concentrating collector, heat is lost due to reflectance loss and the intercept of radiation. In the concentrating collector, there is a reflecting system. Therefore, the heat loss due to reflectance, that means the all radiations are not reflected at a particular point or not focused at a particular point. They also scattered here and there. So there is a loss of heat and the intercept of the radiation. Due to intercept of the radiation, there is also loss of heat. The concentrating collectors have non-uniform flux on the absorber, whereas in a flat plate collector is a uniform. That means in a concentrating collector, the solar radiation focused at a particular point with the help of lens or in reflecting system. So this gives the non-uniform flux on the absorber, but in the flat plate collector, the flux is uniform over all the surface. That means on the absorber, the flux is the uniform. That means we are able to collect the solar radiation at all point with the same intensity. But in the solar concentrating collector, at a particular point where the solar radiation are focused, the intensity is a maximum. That is the non-uniform flux on the absorber. So these all are the disadvantages of the concentrating collectors. This is all about the concentrating collectors. That means we have seen different types of the what do you mean by the concentrating collector, different types of the concentrating collectors, and also it has some advantages as well as disadvantages. We have all covered. So let's see next point. This is the next point of our second chapter, that is the solar distillation. We know all of you what do you mean by the distillation, that is the purification of water or distillation of the water. But what is the actual principle behind it? The basic principle is solar water distillation is the process of using energy from the sunlight to separate fresh water from salt or other contaminants. That means different types of the microbes or salt or some particulate matter. So this is the process in which we are able to obtain the fresh water from the saline water or brine solution. That means it contains different types of microbes, salts and other contaminants. So actually this is the impure form of the water, and in solar distillation we can obtain the pure form of water with the help of solar radiation. The untreated water absorbs the heat slowly, reaching the high temperature. That means the untreated water is exposed to the solar radiation so that it can absorb the heat, and after that the temperature of that water gets increased. The heat causes the water to evaporate, cool and condense into the vapor, leaving the contaminants behind. That means if we expose the impure water to the solar radiation, the temperature of the water gets increased so that it can evaporate, and after that evaporation there is a vapor. So the vapor gets condensed, and after condensation the condensate is the pure form, but this condensate left behind the some material, that means the salt, microbes or some contaminants. So we are able to get the pure form of the water after condensation. This is the actual principle of the solar distillation, or the basic principle of the solar distillation. So we will see detailed working of the solar distillation, but this is the basic principle. Now the construction of the solar distillation, how we can construct the system to obtain the pure form of the water or for the solar distillation. So let's see. The principle of solar distillation is a simple and can be explained with reference to following figure, in which a conventional basin type solar still is shown. The construction of the generally the construction of the solar distillation is a simple. That means in a solar distillation the purpose is we want to obtain only pure form of the water. So the construction is a simple, or principle is a very simple, and with the help of basin type solar still we are able to explain the solar distillation. That means this figure, this is the schematic diagram of basin type solar still. That means it acts as a solar distillation or used for the purification of the water. We will see later, but first we have to see that is the construction. This steel consists of a shallow airtight basin lines with a black coating, impervious material which contains saline water. That means this steel consists of shallow airtight basin lined with black coating. That means this is the which is shown in the figure. The base part, that is the basin, and which is coated with the black, that means the black painted region, so that it is able to absorb the maximum solar radiation which are coming from the sun, and the which helps to increase the temperature of the water which is placed above that, that means which is the filled above that. So this is the basin of the basin type solar steel, and this is the base of that solar steel, and the material which is coated on the basin of the solar steel is an impervious material, that means impenetrable, that means this material is not allowed to penetrate the water, to penetrate the water through that. So this is the property of that material, and which contain the saline water, that means the water which we want to purify. A sloping transparent cover is provided at the top, and which is usually glass or maybe plastic. That means the sloping part which is shown in the figure, that means the upper part of the figure, that is these are the glass, this is the glass or plastic material which is transparent to the solar radiation, that means the solar radiation which are incident on that part, and so that it transmit maximum solar radiation, so that this solar radiation reaches the brine solution or the impure form of the water. So due to this solar radiation, there is a generation of heat, or the temperature of the water gets increased and the water start to evaporate. So but this transparent plate is made up of glass or plastic, so that it is transparent to the solar radiation, that is maximum transparency. The solar radiation is transmitted through the cover and absorbed in the black lining. That means, as shown in the figure, the solar radiation which are incident on the cover plate, that means the glass or plastic, through which the solar radiation transmitted or passes, and after that the solar radiation which are incident on the base, that is indirectly through the water which are incident on the base, and the we know that the heat is transferred layer by layer through the water, and it reaches towards the basin, that means the towards the black coating, and the we know that due to black coating there is a more absorption of the heat, and so that the temperature of the base part of the steel gets increased, and this temperature or this heat is transferred to the water, so that the water get heated or evaporated. After evaporation there is a formation of water vapor which is shown in the figure, that is at the inside part of the enclosure, and this water vapor moves in upward direction, so they moves towards the cover plate or clean glasses or plastic on which they condensate. That means there is a conversion of vapor into water, and this is the cool. So this is where there is a temperature difference. Already there is a temperature difference between the bottom of the solar steel and upper part of the, that is the cover plate. There is a temperature difference between that. That means the temperature of the base part of the enclosure is large as compared to the upper part, because the cover plate only transmit the radiation, but in the base part of the basin or the solar steel there is absorption of the solar radiation. That means the temperature of the base part is large as compared to the cover plate, so there is a temperature difference, and due to temperature difference there is a condensation process. So this is all about the, but the basic elements in the solar steel is the incoming solar radiation, that is the energy or water vapor production from the brine. All the main steps, these all are the main steps which happens in the solar distillation or solar steel. First is the incoming solar radiation, second one is the water vapor production from the brine, and next one is the condensation of water vapor, that is the condensation process, and last one is the collection of the condensate. These all are the four main steps which happens in the basin type solar steel. So we are able to collect the pure form of the water, or we are able to obtain the pure form of the water. So this is the schematic diagram of the basin type solar steel. It consists of different parts. That is, the first is the cover glass or plastic to transmit radiation and condensate vapor. The function of the cover glass or plastic is to transmit the radiation and condensate the vapor, that is the water vapor. And there is a base part, that is the basin, which is coated with a black paint so that it can absorb maximum radiation, and in which the brine water or impure form of the water is filled. And there is a incoming solar radiation which are incident on that surface. But the cover plate are constructed so that it has a slope on both sides, so that the condensate water, so that we are able to collect the condensate water. And there is a two wall, that is inlet and outlet. That is, the first is a distillate or condensate through, and second one is the collection of condensate. This is all about the schematic diagram of a basin type solar steel. Now let's see the actual view of the solar distillation or solar steel type solar steel. Actually, solar steel, basin type solar steel, this is the actual diagram of that. It means it has a transparent cover, and the slope of the transfer current, which is shown in the figure, and there is a base part, and the base part is coated with the black paint so that it can absorb maximum radiation which are coming from the sun and transmitted through the cover plate, and in that the water is filled which we want to purify. This is the actual plant. Now the working of the solar distillation or basin type solar steel. Solar steel works on the principle of solar distillation. A solar steel duplicates the way as the rainwater, that is evaporation and condensation. We know that how we are able to get rainwater. That means there is a water on the earth's surface, so due to solar radiation, heating of that water takes place, so that the temperature of that water gets increased, and after that there is a evaporation process. That means generally sea water, there is evaporation process, and due to evaporation there is a formation of vapors, and these vapors move in a upward direction, and there is a collection of the vapors in the atmosphere, and that is the formation of cloud. And after that, due to surrounding or there is a temperature difference at the earth surface and the atmosphere part, so after that we are able to collect the rainwater. That is, there is a rainy season, in that we get the rainwater. This process is happening in a rainy season. But this principle is also applicable for the solar distillation. That means the principle of the rainwater formation and the solar distillation is the same. That means the duplicate way as a rainwater, that is evaporation and condensation. There is only two process, that is the evaporation and the condensation, through which we get the rainwater. The saline water is filled in the black painted basin of the solar steel. The solar steel consists of the base part, which is coated with a black paint, and in which the saline water is filled. This enclosed in a completely airtight surface and a sloping transparent cover is provided at the top, which is shown in the figure. That means there is an enclosure type part on which the top part is the transparent cover and the airtight surface, because there is a evaporation inside the enclosure. The solar radiation is transmitted through the cover, is absorbed in the black lining. That means if we want to purify the water, the solar radiation are incident on the transferring cover, and this transferring cover transmit the solar radiation, and so that this solar radiation which are transmitted through the cover, which are incident on the black lining, which is at the base of the solar steel, and this solar radiation gets absorbed so that the distillator or the solar steel is designed so that an efficient amount of solar radiation get trapped inside. That means there is a slope on the both side, that is at the right hand side and the left hand side, which is shown in the figure. That means the cover plates are constructed so that the maximum solar radiation gets trapped inside it, so we are able to attain the maximum temperature. This increases the internal temperature of the system, causing the saline water to evaporate, leaving behind all the salt contents, insecticides, bacteria, viruses, etc. That means this slope is constructed, or this slope is given to the transferring plate so that the maximum solar radiation gets trapped inside it, so that the temperature of the water gets increased and the water start to evaporate, but leaving behind all the salt contents, insecticides, bacteria and viruses, so that after evaporation we are able to obtain the purified form of the water. Transparent cover material is cooler than the water surface, as it does not absorb the solar radiation. That means the transparent cover only transmit the radiation. That means the function of the transparent cover only transmit the radiation. That means this part is cooler as compared to the base part, that is the water surface. That means the water surface, the water which is filled inside the solar base and which is coated with the black paint, so that it absorbs the solar, all solar radiation, and the temperature of the water surface is also high due to this. But the cover material is cooler than the water surface, so there is a temperature difference. This temperature difference produces convection currents in air which is trapped inside the enclosure. That means there is a enclosure, all system is enclosed in a enclosure, but some air get trapped in that enclosure. So there is evaporation pressure, evaporation procedure. Due to evaporation, there is a production of humid air, or that is the convection currents. So all this happens due to temperature difference, and these currents bring the humid air into contact with the relatively cool cover and results in a condensation. That means there is a temperature difference. Due to temperature difference, there is a convection currents. That means the convection currents means the to flow. That means the in order to flow the hot vapor towards the covering plate. That means the simply we called it as a convection currents bring the humid air from the surface of the water and bring to this humid air to the contact with the relatively cool cover and result in a condensation. That means the humid air flow from water surface to the transparent cover plate, and on the transparent cover plate the water vapor gets condensed. So that is the condensation process. After that, the condensate pure water is collected in a condensate channel due to inclination provided to the glass covers, and finally fresh water obtained. That means after that procedure, the condensate water which is collected in the condensate channel due to inclination provided to the glass cover. That means there is a slope of the transparent plate, so that the all waters flow in a downward direction after the condensation process, and this water is collected in the condensate channel, and finally we get the fresh water. This is all about the working of the or the how solar distillation process takes place. An output about 3 liters per meter square. That means we get the 3 liters per meter square with an associated efficiency 30 to 35% can be obtained in a well-designed still on a good sunny day. That means if we have the better weather condition, that means we have the solar radiation which has maximum intensity like that. So in that days, we are able to obtain the 3 liter per meter square purified form of the water, and the associated efficiency is the 30 to 35%. But all these happen in a perfect sunny days. So all about the solar distillation process. Now this is all about the solar distillation. That means we have covered what doing by the solar distillation, actually basic principle, what is the basic principle of the solar distillation, and construction of the solar distillation system, that is the basin type solar steel. And we have seen different parts of the solar distillation system, that is the solar steel. That means it consists of transparent cover plate. There is a base part which is coated with a black color. There is an inlet and outlet, and the proper sloping of the transparent cover to the solar radiation. This is all about the solar distillation. And we also discuss about the how we get the purified form of the water. Now in our next video, we will discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of the solar distillation. So we will continue with that.